Before the break, we spoke about the two attributes of Allah, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Qahhar. And now we are going to speak about Al-Wahhab and Al-Razzaq. Al-Wahhab, which is coming from Wahaba, to give, to gift. So we can translate it as the bestower. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the giver, the one who gives you gifts, the one who gives you what he likes without any accounting at all. Anytime he likes. هُوَ الَّذِي يُعْطِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ وَمَتَى شَاءَ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. The one who gives whom he likes, what he likes, whenever he likes, without any accounting at all. And let us take this attribute from the ayah of Surah Ali Imran. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَحَّابُ. O Allah, O Rabb, don't let our hearts incline from the guidance. After that you have guided us. And وَهَبْ لَنَا, give us from yourself رَحْمَةً mercy. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَحَّابُ. You are the one who gives. So that is Wahaba, because when we are going to speak about a Razzaq, there is a slight difference. Wahab, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives anyone whom he likes, what he likes. Yani without means sometime. This what we want to understand here. And another meaning, or you can say the similar meaning, is that he gives duna iwadin, without asking any price for that. And he gives bighayri gharadin, without any motive with him. And he gives without asking. That is again the impression of Al-Wahhab. And in that hadith Qudsi, which is a very beautiful hadith, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Ya ibadi law anna awwalakum wa akhirakum wa insakum wa jinnakum قاموا في سعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل واحد مسألته ما نقص ذلك من عندي مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أذقل البحر. Oh my people, if all of you, right from the beginning till the end, all human beings, all jinn, all of them, they stand in a plane and everyone asks something from me, and I have given everyone what he asked, they are not going to decrease from my kingdom anything except, and this example is given, except that one when a needle is dropped into the sea water. Just imagine how much water could cling to that needle. Nothing. And this is what is going to be decreased from my kingdom. And then he said, Ya ibadi innama hiya a'malukum uhsiha lakum thumma uwaffikum iyyaha faman wajada khayran falyahmadillah wa man wajada ghayra dhalik fala yalumanna illa nafsa. O my people, these are your actions, and I'm just going to count them for you, and then I will bring them, these actions, to you, and with all its rewards. The person who find something good, he should thank Allah. And the person who does not find anything good, he has to blame himself, because he did not do good in this world. And in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَاعْلَمْ لَوْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ اِسْتَمَعَتْ أن ينفعوك بشيء ما نفعوك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك. He said to Abdullah ibn Abbas, if you ask, ask Allah. If you seek assistance, seek the assistance of Allah. And you should know that if the whole ummah, the entire humanity, all the people in this world, all of them, they got together and they wanted to benefit you, they are not going to benefit you except with things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed already for you. And he said, in the same way, if the whole ummah wanted to harm you, with anything, they are not going to harm you except with the thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already recorded it for you. رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامُ وَجُفَّتِ الصُّحُفُ. And that is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after that decree has been written, the pens have been removed and the scriptures or the scrolls in which the decree was recorded has been dried up. Even the ink has dried. So that is the attribute of Allah al-Wahhab. Now let us see some more verses from Al-Quran. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used this word wahaba for a certain action, and that is to give children to a couple. And it shows that this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can it be shared by the human beings? Of course not. He says, لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذُّكُورَ أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ أَقِيمًا إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ. To Allah belongs the kingdom of the heaven and the earth. He creates what He likes. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا. He gives. Look at the word wahaba, which is used here. He gives whom He likes females, whom He likes males, whom He likes, he gives them both males and females, sons and daughters. And He leaves whom He likes barren, without children. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ. He knows and He got the full ability. So, by this we come to understand that Wahhab is the one who gives things nobody can give. That is Al-Wahhab.